SchoolFreeware's free Pascal program tutorials. Tutorial 3, variables and data types. Basically, variables hold data. The data held by the variable can change during the program's operation, and the data type tells the computer what type of data the variable is capable of holding. Here are some common data types. The integer is a whole number. The size of the integer that the computer can hold varies by system. If the variable's number goes too high, then you will experience an overflow. A real data type is a floating point number. It also varies by system. In previous tutorials, we've used strings. Strings are basically text or strings of characters. For example, the text, "Hello World," would be considered a string. A char or char is a single character, for example, the letter A. And the Boolean data type either holds true or false. All code can be downloaded at schoolfreeware.com. I have already made a new program and have put the code to make the computer stop before the program ends down here. So let's go ahead and make a variable. After uses, I'm going to put in var, and this is where our variables go. I'm going to make a variable called name, and name will be a string. So here we have the variable's name, which happens to be name, followed by a colon, and then the data type ending with a semicolon. The name of the variable cannot be a reserved word like begin, end, uses, var, and so on, and it also cannot start with a number. I'll go ahead and make another variable called num1. Even though this variable name has a number in it, it is not starting with a number, and num1 will be an integer. Make another variable called num2, and I'll set num2 to be a real, which is a floating point number. And finally, c will be a char. And we're done with the variables, and that's all the variables we're going to use within this tutorial. So I'll just go down to where we begin, and I'll start off with the name. We'll have name becomes, and since name is a string, I'll have to put my information within single quotes. The name will be School Freeware. And with a semicolon, and this reads name becomes School Freeware. You can also say that name is holding the information School Freeware. So School Freeware and name right now are basically the same thing. So I can right line the information that name is holding to the screen by just simply putting in name. So therefore we should have School Freeware printed up there on the screen. Okay, everything checks out. So let's go work with num1. So I'll go ahead and set num1 to become 3. And I'll write line num1, go ahead, run. 3 is printed up there on the screen. That is good. Okay. I'll go ahead and change num1 so it becomes 10. And then I'll write line the contents of num1 up there on the screen. So here the information within the variable has changed. So we should have 3 and then 10 printed up there on the screen, which we do. Okay, moving on. I'll set num2 to equal 3.3 since this is a floating point number. And I'll write line num2 up there on the screen. And of course, this is a real floating point number. So I'm expecting to see scientific notation, which I do. Num2, I'm going to set its character position to 0. And since we only have one decimal place, I'll just put in a 1 there. Okay, go ahead, run. That looks good. 3.3. All right, time for C becomes, and then within single quotes, I can put any character I want. I'll just put a percent sign in there. And I'll right line the contents of C to the screen. Okay, go ahead, Ryan. There it is. Now I like to take num1 and add it to num2 to show that we can take the variables and make a calculation out of them. So I'll write line num1 plus num2. And then since I know that num2 is a floating point, I'm going to put 0, 1 there so I can prevent the scientific notation from showing up. Now go ahead and run this. And 13.3, of course, 10 plus 3.3, that is correct. Before we go ahead and quit, I'm going to show what happens if you try to put in a data type that is not what the computer is expecting. So here we have name as a string, and if I just remove this string here and try to put in a number, say like 3, and go ahead and run, we should get an error immediately. Yes, we do. So I'm going to undo this. Back to school freeware. Now for num1, it's expecting an integer, so I'm going to try giving it a floating point number, like so. See what happens. Again, an error message. So I'll put it back to a integer. I can also try to see if num1 will accept the string. I would imagine not. No, it doesn't accept 10, even though we consider 10 to be a number. When it is within single quotes, the computer considers that to be a string. So whatever's within single quotes, no matter if it's a number or not, the computer will consider that to be a string of characters and not really a number. Moving on for our character here, basically we are allowed one character, so I'm going to see what happens if I put in several characters, if the computer will accept that. And no, it doesn't. So definitely make sure that you're using the correct data type with your variable, otherwise you'll quickly get an error and nothing will compile or run. So I'll run this once again, this to verify that everything is working out. Everything is fine. For the next tutorial, we will get user input.